Hey guys, what's up? It's Kenzie and welcome back to my channel. I'm getting comfortable. Today's video, I just wanted to do a Q&A so we could catch up and talk. It is January 4th as I am filming this. If you guys are new here, be sure to subscribe. I've been posting and I'm about to be posting so many vlogs. If you guys liking the daily vlogs better, obviously not every single day, don't get ahead of yourself, but like, would you rather see a daily vlog as opposed to a weekly vlog? Like, let me know what you think. I don't know. Subscribe, follow me on Instagram, check out my podcast, all of that. Ask on Instagram for some questions, so be sure to follow my Instagram. I will have it on the screen and it's always linked down below. Also, who likes my All You Need Is Juicy t-shirt? Me. I got a lot of questions on how to manage money. Guys, I have no idea. I'm not good at it. I listen to what my dad tells me to do, but overall, I still am not good at it. And honestly, like, it's so weird right now. I was just telling Yana this the other night, but the two things that I was like the least interested in the world in would be like cooking and finances. For some reason, I'm like, wait, I wanna know and be smart and invest and do all of this stuff all of a sudden. Like, I don't know what happened to me. It all happened in the past few weeks. So I bought a book on finances and I'm gonna learn. So that actually is one of my goals this year, is to just be like way smarter with my money, learn more, just kind of like understand it better, because I still am like, I know more probably than the most 21-year-olds, because I don't get my taxes taken out of my paychecks, like stuff like that, but I don't know much. I just know like slightly more, I think. And maybe I don't even know more, but yeah. And all of a sudden, I'm like super into cooking and I wanna learn how to cook. It's literally the weirdest thing that's ever happened to me. I don't know what's going on. Right now, I know 3 recipes, 2 of which I've learned from Joe. So I'm gonna be learning more this year. What kind of content do you want to create this year? I think I'm obsessed with Maggie McDonald right now. I'm probably annoying to her. Like, I comment on everything, I respond to everything, I tell her I'm obsessed with her like every other day. But I love her vlogs, like, and they're just a lot of the time, like, my favorite ones are her at home just talking, like, nothing else, not going anywhere. I just love those vlogs. So, and I think I like them because they're daily, so I don't know. She's definitely inspired me to be vlogging, like, daily more. I love her. My favorite YouTuber probably ever. I'm, like, literally obsessed with her. So I want to be doing that. I want to be doing a lot of videos. Like, I really liked my 5 a.m. morning routine. I just want to be doing more fun videos. I really want to do a video where I do like a day in the life of like another YouTuber. I've already talked to like a few of them and I do like a whole day. I don't go a day in their life. I do a day with them. I have this whole idea, whatever. If you guys have any YouTubers want me to do that with, let me know. Do you see yourself living in LA long term? I know this is gonna shock a lot of you guys, but yes, I do. If it wasn't for Zoe, I don't think that I would feel that way, but now I just have such a strong like community and family here, and realistically, just like career-wise and stuff, like I for a while really thought I was gonna eventually go back to Texas, and maybe I still will. Like, I'm not against it, and I'm definitely not against having a house there. I just love Texas, but as of right now, I really cannot see myself leaving. Like, I, for the first time in my life, can see myself, like, raising a family here, which is really, really weird because I've never wanted that here. I didn't really want to raise a family until the past year, to be fair, but, like, now I can see myself doing it here, and something in me just tells me I'll be here forever. But I could be wrong, so who knows? What's one habit you want to incorporate into your routine for 2019? I want to be waking up earlier. I've always been like waking up kind of earlier, but I want to be waking up at like 6 naturally minimum. I really like when I wake up at 5, like when I have those extreme mornings. It's so nice to have that. But yeah, if you guys have any tips for waking up early, please let me know. Favorite place to buy joggers? I don't know. I actually don't have many good pairs of joggers. Like, any, the joggers that I like are actually my old merch. So like, those are the only ones I really like. Then I have these gray pair from H&M that I wear all the time, just like around the house or whatever. I wear them in public sometimes too, I probably shouldn't, but they're really comfortable. But I don't have good joggers. Let me know where you guys buy your joggers. I literally for like 2 years I wanted a Champion matching set. I need to just buy it and try out Champion sweats, like the ones from Urban, like the, I don't know what they're called. Why am I blanking on it? I do know what they're called, I'm just blanking on it. So, you guys let me know. High school advice. Enjoy it while you're in it. I think I didn't hate high school, and when I was in high school, I never thought I hated it, but I think I was just like ready to go do something else. And I look back in high school, and obviously I think looking back on things, it always is like better than what you thought. But I think that I could have just like enjoyed the time that I had there more. don't be the person that hates everyone. That's so annoying. Like, it's, and it's also like, if you're the one person who hates everyone around you, like, the common denominator is you. So just like people and try to enjoy your time there. Like, everyone has to do it, and I know that it's not the best time for everyone, and for some people it is, but it really is what you make of it. So yeah, for me personally, I would have just wished that I would have enjoyed my time more. But I did enjoy high school, and I loved the school that I went to. Like, I loved my high school. So I didn't like hate it, but I was always like ready to go do something else. Because I was also really focused on YouTube when I was in high school. I still am. But yeah, that's just my advice. Please let us know how you're liking Orange Theory. I recently signed up. So, if you guys don't watch my vlogs or follow me on Instagram, you guys don't know this, but I recently joined Orange Theory maybe like 8 days ago, I think, at this point. It's January 4th. I've already taken 6 classes. I love it. Like, it is so fun. I love Soul Cycle and I love everything else. I think I might like Orange Theory a little bit more than Soul Cycle, maybe. Like, they're pretty up there. The thing with like Soul Cycle, I feel like I get a better workout in Orange Theory, and I feel like I'm kind of able to do more. I love boxing, so like I do miss that. But with Orange Theory, I pay $160 a month for my unlimited membership, and if you take like 5 classes at SoulCycle, it's $150. So like, you save so much money, and Orange Theory is just fun. Like, I really, really enjoy it. I can do more videos like later if you guys have like more specific things, but I like love Orange Theory so far. Definitely. I started going because Brooke and Danielle have talked about it for forever, and so I was asking them so many questions before, and I really love it. Like, it's just so fun. And I feel so much better once I leave the class. Like, I worked out this morning. I've been working out like pretty much every morning since I got back, and it's just so good. Like, oh my gosh, it's so good. If any of you guys live in LA and you go to Orange Theory, like, let me know. Let's go together. I'm serious. What are you looking forward to at ZLC this semester? So when I'm filming this, my orientation is tomorrow for this semester, and I was just thinking about how much I've grown and how much things have changed in the past year, and like, I can't imagine more. So I was just like, it's just crazy. I'm just really excited to like see what I learn and stuff. I love my school so much. It's just so fun. I mean this totally respectfully, but where'd you get the scar on your forehead? I have one too. So like, the scars, you can probably see them. I don't know, you can see them for sure. When I was younger, I like love my dad. My dad is an angel to me. He can do no wrong. He's my favorite person in the world. But when I was younger, I was like daddy's girl to the extreme. And he was like, I think both my parents were down there. But like, that's my point. Like, this is like what I love my mom too, to death. But I was just like obsessed with my dad when I was younger. That's like kind of unrelated to the story, but I just think that he was down in the basement watching his show, and that's why I went to the basement. But anyways, I had like the sippy cups, you know what I'm talking about? Like, does anyone else call them that? And I fell down the stairs in the basement, like back when we lived in St. Louis. Like, I was like under 2, and I like didn't let go of it, and it kept like hitting my head. So I had to get a bunch of stitches, and that's the story with that. And apparently I didn't even cry. I'm like, I would cry now, but I was tough. Who are your favorite YouTubers? We've already gone through this. Maggie McDonald right now. I love Gretchen. I like all my friends, like Keaton. I just am super into vlogs. Like, those are my favorite videos for sure. What goes into planning for each podcast episode? Do you plan all of your questions? So, for my podcast, the I Love You So Much podcast, it is always linked down below. For each episode, I make like a loose outline. The way, like, when a guest comes in, I'm like, if we go on a tangent and it's totally off topic, that's okay. I have like key things that I probably plan on hitting, and if we don't hit those, it's fine, because that just means that it's more conversational. I don't really want it to be an interview. I want it to be like very conversational. I don't want it to be like question, answer, question, answer. That's not what I want. So I have like a very loose outline. I do have my hot seat questions ready, and then I'll outline like maybe 3 or 4 major points, specific questions under there and stuff. But if I'm like, depending on how close I am with the person, like if I'm not as close with them, I probably stick more to the outline just so I know like more to say. But yeah, I don't know. I do have a loose outline, but I don't always like go. Like, there's been times where we go completely off the outline, so it just depends. What apps do you use for devotion on your iPad Pro? By the way, I love you. I love you too. I was just showing my grandma these the other day. When I didn't have social media on my phone, or just didn't do social media for like 3 weeks in like October or something, I was in Georgia with Danielle, and she's like, what do you even do on your phone now? Cause like, I do see you on your phone sometimes, but like, what are you doing? And I was like, I'm literally on YouVersion doing devotions. Like that is the point. That is what I had gotten to. Like that was like October 20th and I was getting back on the 21st. Right now I'm doing one on the She Reads Truth app. But yeah, like either YouVersion or She Reads Truth. YouVersions are free, She Reads Truths are like $2. What iPad Pro apps are your favorite so far? Google Calendar. I've been planning digitally this year. It's very new for me. It's a very big deal. You know, I've been on my passion planner for like 3 years. If you guys want a video, let me know. I got the like Procreate app, whatever. I don't know. I wanna know. I need to learn how to do like graphic stuff on my iPad Pro and do the thumbnails and like the little illustrations. If any of you guys know and you're good at this or know good videos that can teach me, I can probably do some on Skillshare actually. Maybe I'll do them on Skillshare. Let me know because I need to know that stuff. Favorite songs at the moment. Because I've been working out a lot, I really like rap just in general because that's my favorite to like work out to. And then besides that, lately I literally have a jazz playlist that I like. It's called 4 PM in my office on my Spotify that I listen to all the time. I love that, like Frank Sinatra, like that kind of stuff. Literally, that's what I've been listening to right now. It's either rap or jazz music from like the 60s. So I'm literally been getting so many questions about sex lately. I don't know where this is coming from. It's just like, I don't know. I don't really have anything to say. I just have so many questions. Like, I don't know why. Would you ever consider coming back to Chicago for another meetup? I would love to. I love Chicago. It is one of my favorite cities. I've actually spent a lot of time there. Love that city. And the meetup there was huge, so I would definitely want to go back. How do you stay focused? I think I get very unfocused too. I think like midday, between like 1 to 3:30, I'm kind of in this like weird slump and I'm like tired or whatever. Let me know if you guys have any tips for the midday slump, but I always have to-do lists. I always have things planned out. So I just kind of power through it and I just keep doing it. Like before I started filming all these videos just now, I filmed a video before this and this one, I was like, I need to get in the zone and like focus, but I just couldn't. And I went in my room, I put on a bunch of, or I lit a bunch of candles, listened to jazz music, made a coffee, and now we're here. Which music artist are you most excited to hear from in 2019? I'm always most excited to hear from Kacey Musgraves. I don't know if she's releasing anything this year, because she just, maybe she is, because she, I don't know. Just Kacey at all times. I love her. Also, I'm not that impressed with Coachella's lineup at all, but then I saw Kacey is going to be there. So I will, that's all I needed. Like that's literally all I needed. Imagine if Dua Lipa was going to Coachella though, and then it was Dua Lipa and Kacey Musgraves. Wow. Hi, what impressions or feelings do you want people to get from you? Like first impressions. This is something that I've been thinking about for like ever, but I think a lot of the time, well first off, I'm like very outgoing and very friendly. And like I go out of my way to be nice to people, like I genuinely do, and I'm also from Texas, so it's just normal. But then like occasionally there'll be that person that's like, oh, I was really intimidated by you when I met you, or oh, I was really, I thought you were like this or that or whatever. And it's like, I'm genuinely nice to people. If I wasn't like sucking up to them or something when I met them or like whatever it is, I think some people are, if you're like comfortable with yourself, I don't know how to say this without sounding kind of rude, but I think for girls especially, if you're a confident girl or someone who's like typically like more secure, just in general, we aren't like sucking up to this person. And like, I think people meet you and sometimes they just expect you to like bow down to them. I don't know, it's like this weird thing, especially if you're a girl who has any sort of social media following and someone knows that before. I don't know, I think people are like, oh, I thought you were this and that. I think a lot of the time it says a lot more about them than it does about you, because like when I meet people, and like maybe they're a little standoffish or whatever, like my first assumption is, oh, like they're probably just having an off day, or like they didn't mean it like that, it was just taken like that or whatever. I'm never like, oh, they're this and they're that, you know? I don't know. I just think that it says a lot more about them than you. But also, like I'm sure I could be better at it and stuff, but I feel like I'm like very like, hi, nice to meet you, I'm Kenzie, whatever. But I think like when you're a big crowd, sometimes it's hard to like be like, hey, whatever, so it's like kind of awkward when you don't want to like interrupt something, and you know what I'm saying? So I'm sure it's like more situations like that, but just in general, like if you meet someone and you think, like, I don't know, I would like them to think, to answer your question, I would like them to think that I was welcoming and friendly. That's it. What are some of your resolutions or goals for 2019? Something that I want to be better about. One, managing finances, and then two, Joe has said this before a billion times, but like as far as getting things done, I will get things done left and right, but if they're like a minuscule task that doesn't really matter, and it's like small and it's just like whatever, I'll put it off for forever. So I want to be better about just like taking care of the smaller things as well, because then it'll get to something where I'm like, oh, I should do that, you know? How do you remain such a positive person, obsessed with your podcast and your videos? I'm in a good mood right now, but I wouldn't say I'm a negative person. I'm gonna like twist this question. I'm not a negative person. But I think especially now, like I am definitely going through a harder time and I'm not always like upbeat and like happy and whatever by any means. But like obviously when I'm filming, that's what, like I want my videos to be upbeat. So I typically like, I cannot tell you how many times in the past like month I've stopped a vlog and just not done it because like I've crashed midday or like had a really bad day or whatever. And I don't wanna post something that's like super negative all the time. So I am positive for sure, but I do go through harder times and I do have bad days. I just don't post that or broadcast that. This is like a highlight reel. I don't wanna say my YouTube channel is really a highlight reel because like maybe my Instagram is, but I like am very open and like I tell you guys things. I don't only show the highs, but I definitely show way more highs than I do like lows. You know what I mean? And then I got a lot of questions of, are you dating someone? No, I'm not dating anyone, even though people keep asking me questions. I am not, I promise you. So that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I feel like this is a little bit longer. I personally really like long videos because I love Maggie's long vlogs, so I like long videos. If you guys let me know in the comments down below how long you typically like videos, like 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 30, you let me know. If you guys haven't already, be sure to subscribe. I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys soon.